Okay, I'm back. What, that you can close Streamlabs while it's live? And then pop back in and go live again? Did you not know that? You got a commercial. Oops. The question is, sometimes it won't count it as a new stream if you're fast enough. Sometimes it does. Yeah, like Streamlabs is counting this as a new stream for me. And my bit rate has suddenly dropped, and it is now flagging issues. Okay. Getting everything stabilized. You back, Kiri? Are you still stuck in a commercial? You're here. Okay. I'm watching my own stream without lag. And it hasn't lagged for the 2-ish minutes I've been streaming. So I'm going to cautiously try to get everything set back up. And we will see how it goes. Welcome to the world of sometimes Dark Souls. There we go. Yep, I think you're good to play. Let me know if it starts to lag again. I'll try to hardwire for tomorrow. Because I got. Oh, can I reach him? I can. Nope, I can't. I can't reach them. They are just out of reach. I have PLCs. That's what I'm trying to say. I have PLCs. No, I wanted to use the bonfire. They may or may not be unintentionally borrowed from a prior place of employment. And you know immediately what I'm talking about when I say prior place of employment that would potentially have had PLCs if I was, like in theory, working temporarily in a department. Anyway. You have an Ethernet cable running through the walls, so I don't know if that helped, but I might be worth looking into because I have too many devices. I think they're pretty cool. I think they're a pretty cool device. They're good if you can't do a hardwired run. That's when they really kind of shine. But you know what, they are what they are. Que sera, sera. Okay. Might be a tad familiar. Ah, that place. She needs more bandwidth. I mean, you might be able to. I'm so glad that you are oblivious, because that just went right next to you and you did not react, dude. I'm not an expert when it comes to internet bandwidth. So, ooh. Ooh. It's the magic flying stick. I wonder where I can get one of those. You know what? I feel like using the sword. I like this sword. Do I play Warframe? No, but I have thought about picking it up. Hello, good sir. Why, hello there. Do you have a moment to talk about my sword? It's a nice sword. I love this sword. Would you like to talk about my sword, sir? Oh, ma'am. I'm sorry, you're a ma'am. So Imani, Ko, Merrick, and Brenton have all picked it up like a month ago. Okay, I'll have to take a look into it. And for what it's worth, I know who Armani is, but I do appreciate the little reminder note there. Whoa! Oh, nose! Oh, all the nose, all the nope nopes. Nope, the nope. Nope, 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 nope. Nope, nopes. It might be fun for you to get in on. They can stop complaining about dumb Randying in the squad. Randy's not Randying. Randy's not Randying. Oh, I get what you're saying. Randos. I always said randos. Oh, hi, friend. I'm gonna need to take out that Cyclops, aren't I? Yeah. Well, guess what? There's a building. Oh, that would have killed me. I'm so glad. Just stop. Tad bit of slow-mo on the graphics. I could see that just everything that was going on, to be fair. We'll keep an eye on it. I'm definitely getting some. So, it seems to be getting better if I'm according to my logs. But I keep getting occasional little error messages pop up. So I'm tracking it now. I'm kind of actively tracking it a bit. There's been a couple dropped frames, but it's been less and less. Oh, it's just you. Okay, you two done? Probably not. The range on those spells is insane. Am I doing game capture or screen capture? I am doing game capture. Because it tends to be a little cleaner for me. I could try switching it to screen capture, but I think that'd actually make the issue worse. If it does get bad, I will switch, though. Just to try. I just wish one of these guys would drop Twinkling Titanite. Yeah. No, I appreciate the spitballing. My response was in no means to disagree. It was to share my experience and opinion. Which is, that's a very good idea, and I will probably try it if it comes. Yeah. I know I have RBF, it can come off as condescending sometimes, so I try not to. Your computer hated game capture. Did your computer die? Wait, did I address this? Did your computer die, and did I miss this part of a conversation if it's been brought up before? Like, genuinely, I have a terrible memory, and if it has been brought up to me, I apologize because I probably genuinely forgot. I have the memory of a goldfish. Oh, you see, so the thing is, and I don't know if you're aware of this. Okay. I hadn't noticed that you hadn't been streaming. So this week I hadn't streamed until today, because I was unpacking. The week before that, I was driving across the country with my wife and kids, and the week before that, I was packing up my stuff to move. So I haven't, like, touched Twitch in, like, 2.5 weeks. Almost 3 weeks. So, like, I've just kind of, like, been gone for a lot longer, and anything that happened during that time I completely missed, and the time before that even I wasn't paying very good attention, just because I was really busy. Things are just kind of slowing down again. But the good news is I'm with my wife and kids again, so. I think you dipped your computer about the same time. Timely makes sense. There we go. I'm also incredibly happy. Have them again. I was originally going to try to make this like, oh yay, we're all together, let's kind of like get them on the stream, and then my kid just like crashed hard. Like all of the crashing, it became nap time, he was gone. And then my wife was like, oh, we'll just get the baby to sleep and just for you tonight. See ya. Ah, there's the last one I needed. ECBU had a meltdown and committed some pot. Okay. They do that, yeah. It's really funny. We got him. So my kiddo is 5. You will see him on streams occasionally because he absolutely loves to join me on streams. He's done it over Discord a couple times, but now his chaos will be in the flesh, so to speak. But kiddo's 5, and we got him Animal Crossing for the Switch for his birthday because he's been obsessed with it. Because my mom plays that game. And so today, just all day, he's like, can you stream Animal Crossing? Can you stream Animal Crossing? And I had to like explain to him that I don't have a capture card, so I can't stream it. And he just didn't understand that. And he was kind of sad. And I think he thinks I'm like chipping him out of an Animal Crossing stream when it's something I genuinely can't do. And I feel a little bit bad. So, needless to say, this is the story of how I decided I'm getting a capture card. Because I have a very soft spot for my children. And they know this. And I think they slightly abuse it, to be honest. I'll be around. If I make it back, you can be around. Let's see, do you have a Titanite chunk I can buy? Nope, that was embarrassing. You have three. Let me buy all three. Because I can do some decent upgrading with that. Yes, it's me again. I got more Titanite chunks. Let's upgrade those. Wouldn't it be awesome to stream with him? Oh, wait. Animal Crossing does have multiplayer. And we are considering getting a second set of Joy-Cons. And very specifically, one of the reasons why I wanted it is so that I could stream that with him. He's not... He's very much at an age where kind of like advanced controls.
Oh my God.
Advanced controls, like Animal Crossing controls, are a little bit beyond him. He's a very fast learner. He's got the joysticks down. He can't read, though. So... I gotta kind of do the reading for him, which isn't a problem. And there's a lot of, like... Like, not... This is not a big deal. Like, he doesn't... He just wants to run around. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. But it's like, he's not like... He could care less that he needs to get miles to pay off Tom Nook. He just wants to run around picking up sticks and collecting bugs. And that's... That's just perfect right there. He's pretty much the same whether in game or in real life. And then obviously we got the one-year-old, and the one-year-old is just happy to be involved whatever I'm doing. It doesn't matter what it is. She's just like, oh, I'm here. We're good. This is the good times. Did I reinforce my weapon? I did. I was going to go sell stuff. Where is... Doors of Pharaohs? Oh, I have incredibly children. And lucked out immensely because of that. Like, Pip, the older one, is... Or Pippin, is a little ball of chaos. And I love him. He's chaos. He doesn't, like, do things to be, like, bad. If that makes sense. He's not rebellious. He's only five. But it's, like, the eternal energy of 1,000 burning suns. A very short attention span. And a lot of unpredictability. And I love him dearly. But he can be a handful because of this. The other one, though, the baby's fine. Like, genuinely fine. Like, she's just starting to, as I like to say, just starting to toddle. So there's, like, general, like, toddle, like, oh, nope, what are you doing? Don't put that in your mouth. Ah, no, kind of stuff. But, like, she's pretty good, too. She's very chill, doesn't have a lot of needs. It's just kind of like, oh, whatever. I'm just going to do my little thing. And then if it's quiet, you know something's wrong. That's just parenting 101. Well, hello, Moth. Thank you for the 5-month subscription. Ooh, indeed. How are you doing, Moth? Yeah. No, you hear silence and you have children, something bad is happening. Like, if you have multiple children, one of them is most likely dead. It's maybe a little over-exaggeration, but not by much. Good, Mango Stream died for unknown reasons. I'm thinking there might have been Twitch issues going on earlier if Mango Stream died. Because we were experiencing lagging on this end earlier. That makes me feel better to hear Mango ran into some issues. Not that Mango ran into issues makes me feel better, but I was, like, worried it was going to be my internet, or... I almost just smacked that guy with the sword, and I would have been really, really sad. Gavlon is friend. Anyway, my house, it always meant someone was messing around in the bathroom with the faucets. Oh, that's like... yes. Or fire. I have a bit of a passion for fire, we'll call it. And both of my children at a very young age have already expressed a similar fascination. And I do not know what future hell I have unleashed upon myself because of it. So I gotta teach them young how to be safe about it. Because I know far too much about the sparky flames for my children's thing. My problem is I'm the kind of parent whose gut reaction is not always the best parental instinct of safety. I tend to say my kid invented something that made a mess or went boom or something and it was a little bit potentially dangerous. I tend to forget to be the parent and tend to default to fellow engineer, as seen by the time that there was me and like 13 5-year-olds and we saw how much water pressure we could make in a pipe system at a Discovery Center for Children. I am aware of this and I'm a little bit proud of it. And I would maybe quantify it as good parenting on my part. I just know that there are parents that disagree, given all of the parents at said Discovery Center responding to us managing to get the water, which was supposed to have very low pressure, shoot up in the foot, in the sky by a good amount of feet. Look, if you're gonna make, like, a baking soda and vinegar bomb, let's say, and we're gonna say baking soda and vinegar for safety, I want you to make the best one you can. I hate this place. But I got the flamey sword. So come at me, bro. The crystals are pretty. I just hate this area because there's a lot of poison. And then there's like corners like this where it's like... There it is. Lots of, like, little corners it's very easy to get backed into. Okay, there we go. Okay. Oh, I'm not dead. I love the staff. We have the staff... This staff is awesome because it can do both hexes and miracles. Wait, it's both a catalyst and a charm, or chime, which means it can do both miracles and sorceries, but it's actually tailored towards dark, so it can do hexes of both the miracle kind and the sorcery kind. Which makes it actually a very powerful catalyst staff thing. We're gonna go down here. This looks more interesting. And I've been using it for a while. I picked up the sword because one, it looks cool. It's like a two-handed falchion, a bit kind of worn and scarred. I just like the way that it looks. It's a really good great sword in my opinion. I love the move set because you got the slash in the one hand. It's good for stunning. The backstab damage is amazing. You have a solid heavy hit. You can chain the heavy hits. Let me get my stamina up to kind of show this. They chain pretty well with the heavy hits. Chains pretty good there. And then you can switch it to two-hand when you really want to do some damage. You got those swiping strikes still. But where it really shines is the heavy two-handed hits if you want to take something out pretty quick. You can hit with three fast hits real quick. So I just love the moveset. It's also got a very unique property. This sword gets stronger every new game cycle. So new game plus, new game plus plus, new game plus plus, three plus, etc. It gets stronger, which means it's one of the few weapons that it actually scales with how difficult your game mode is, which makes it very, very viable when you start to do new game cycles. Most people actually don't use it on this like base level, but I do because of the move set. But yeah, it's kind of demonic looking, and I like it. Okay, what do we got in here? Death ahead. Despair ahead. Yeah, that's just a murder hole. I know you, Dark Souls. I ain't jumping down there. Your head out? Is nice chatting, though? Of course! Thank you so much for swinging by as long as you did, Kiri. Also, Moth, that's Kiri. It's Kiri secretly stealthing on the hubby's account because you missed the earlier conversation. Oh, hi, friend. I forgot you stood there. You still lurking around, Moth? Oh, I was not paying attention. Let's see if we can snipe the archer out. The answer is no. Hey, you're lurking. Of course, that's fine. You're more than welcome. There's the random fact. I had a feeling you were going to redeem one. Oh, it's a good one. It's been so long. Random fact. Any subject, any preferred subject? Moth. Any preferred subject? I can't guarantee that I'll have a random fact of that subject, but I guess something to poke me in a direction, as it were. Oh yeah, you aren't dead yet. Like a specific subject would help. Just mostly to kind of give me ideas. Oh goodness, there's a lot of you up here. You're bad at thinking of what? No, you're good. Let's throw out a couple random ones. There is a time. Let's go. Let's start with a history one that I like. Kind of like a random one. If you have a subject that comes up, we'll do one from there. But a random history one that I've recently learned, is there's a story Let me double check the credibility on this fact, actually. I'll share the story either way, but let me just do a double check on the credibility. Credibility check, as it were. No, I'm not updating my phone. Okay. If you think of a subject in the meantime. Okay, there is a story, and this is actually a fairly reasonably real story. There was a battle in ancient China, and the two sides kind of lined up. One of the sides, and I'm not going to try to pronounce any of these names because that would be bad. I will mispronounce all of the names. I'm very, very unskilled when it comes to pronouncing, I'm going to use the phrase Asian names, but any name, there's a couple different names, but in this case, Asian names, and this happened in China, basically in ancient China, around, 613 BCE, what happened was there was basically the purported battle, the two armies lined up, and one of the two armies brought with them a juggler. This juggler walked out onto the field of battle with 9 balls and proceeded to juggle them in front of the enemy army. The enemy army was immediately captivated by it. And there's a couple different stories. One of the variations of the story is that thinking that he was a wizard, that army kind of packed up and left after he was juggling 9 balls. There's another one which is probably a little bit more realistic, which is while they were all staring at the jugglers, the other army ambushed them. But yeah, that is a time in ancient China that a juggler helped win the battle, which is just a very unique niche thing. And it's called Why Bards Are Dangerous. Never underestimate the bard. Have we talked about Welsh longbowmen? This is another random fact. And the origin of why, in England, raising 2 fingers is an insult, rather than, like, just the middle finger. Or the middle finger in general, I could talk about where that came from. I don't know if I have or not before. Yep, I have talked about it. Okay. Well, hello, Mash Mangoes. Thank you for the sub. Subscribe for 5 months as well. You guys are some of my earliest subscribers. Hello. No clue where the middle finger comes from. I'm falling. Is this... He got me on auto sub. Well, I really appreciate that. I hope to return, now that things are kind of stabling out for me in Massachusetts, I hope people return to the favor with a couple people. Because I always really enjoy your streams. I've just been... You always stream when I'm busy. Not that that's your fault. It's just a coincidence. Anyway, but random fact. So for those of you who are wondering, because I did bring it up, the reason why in England raising these two fingers in a, what we would maybe say, like, a backwards peace sign. Like, this is fine, but to show the back of the hand is an insult in England. And the reason behind it, one of the many theories is that, basically Welsh longbowmen would use those two fingers to draw arrows, and it was known that if a Welsh longbowman or longbowmen in general, but Wells was known for the longbowmen at this time, were captured, particularly by the French, they would actually cut those two fingers off because it was basically a way to take them out of commission in a reasonably, per medieval standards, humane way. You weren't killing them, you're only taking away their ability to shoot a bow. So a lot of Welsh archers started to basically to act as an insult, show the two fingers over walls as kind of like a threat or a ha-ha, you haven't caught me, you're not going to catch me, kind of little taunt. The middle finger, though, is much more simple. It's actually a very, very old hand sign. We know it traces back to ancient Rome. It could even trace back to ancient Greece and even longer than that. But we do have complete historical archaeological evidence of ancient Romans using it as an insult or as a vulgar hand sign. So it's a very, very old one. It's very, very simple. The most common thing that you hear about it in English is that it means, like, kiss my A or something like that. The actual origin of it is much more simple. It's the fact that it looks like male anatomy. That's what it means. You're just making your hand look like male anatomy to aim at someone else's general direction as an insult. That's what it comes from. Very straightforward. People have always been people. There are, just like historically speaking, like there's so many times like archaeologists find something and they think it's going to be revolutionary. Like they go into ruins and they see that someone has written something really high up on the wall and they go to translate it and then it just says, Hiroki wrote this up high. Just some dude being bored in a cave who like vandalized the wall. It's like a true thing that happened. They found like an ancient ruin where, like, there was, like, little markers, and one was that someone wrote that they had written higher on the wall than anyone else. Someone else wrote that they were, you know, sleeping around. Like, people are always people. Yeah, no, that's legit. That's where it comes from, at least in ancient Rome. Like, the meaning nowadays is a little bit more of just an insult. It's ambiguous, but in ancient Rome, it was phallic. That was the reason for it. It was one of the many, many ways ancient cultures were obsessed with phalluses. To throw another word out there that you may or may not have needed to know. I don't know how well known that word is. I mean, I think I've also talked about this a little bit before. Cuss words in general. Have I talked? Are you still there, Moth? I don't know if you're. I don't know if any of these random facts are interesting to you, or you're have completely tuned out of it. And you were the one who redeemed it. So, you're here. Have I talked at all on the stream about why certain words are why we have vulgar words and what that comes from? Have I talked about that on stream before? Because this is something else that I find fascinating. Ouch. Where are you? You're not sure. It's a fly. Don't make me kill the bug. I like the bugged friend. Sorry. Okay. Well, so the word, first off, the word vulgar just, it comes from the Latin word for basically common. It's vulgar as in that it's a common speak. And what these words actually come from it's actually a little bit interesting. Basically, English has kind of two main roots, and kind of at the time for where most of what we would consider vulgar words comes from is particularly like in English, it's medieval Europe. And what you had is you had commoners who generally spoke at the time Anglo-Saxon, which is kind of the majority of the base of English. It's a very Germanic language, along with English. And you had nobility that spoke French. And what happened is certain words that were commonly used by the lower class in ancient Greece to refer to things like, or ancient England, medieval England, not ancient. So things, words for like butt and poop, etc. You know the words I'm talking about. Those words, or the F word, were used, they were just common. They are very German words, which is why if you look at those words' counterparts in German, Scheiße, Ark, I'm not going to say the F one because it just has an I instead of a U, and that was a bit too close for me. But if you look at those, it's why they're so similar. It's just literally was just them using the same word in German. And when they were marked as vulgar words, it wasn't because their meaning was bad, it was because commoners used them. You were speaking common. It's a very classist thing, to be honest. Which is really, really funny because it actually, one of the most interesting places this bleeds over is in biblical translations, where if you were to translate them much more honestly, there's certain people in the Bible who very much have a mouth, which kind of creates this duality when you're talking about like translating scriptures. In terms of like from Greek to English, because in English we have a very strong taboo, but that didn't exist then. So they kind of just said the words as it was. Because the concept of that, it's very much born out of medieval aristocracy. And saying those words was bad because you were speaking common, not because the words had an innately rude meaning. Even the word vulgar doesn't actually mean bad. It does kind of nowadays, it means bad, but originally it's just the word for common. They were just being peasants. They were being beneath upper class society. So yeah. I feel like that's gonna break my armor. Yep, it broke my armor. Gosh dang it. I recognize that to be acid, but. Makes sense. It's also why, not to get theological, but when you hear like the most common like scriptural quotes for not cussing, like thou shalt not take the Lord's name in vain type stuff, it's much more often interpreted to be about making false oaths and broken promises. Is probably a more accurate depiction than it being anything about saying bad words. And again, there is some debate there. But, yeah. I seem to have found myself strapped in a hole. So, homeward bone it is. Anyway. Ah, ba ba da ba ba. I recently went on a rant at work because someone mentioned the word bougie. And it started getting me talking about the origin of the word bourgeoisie, which is where bougie comes from. know why I mentioned that. I was just also on my mind talking about the origins of words. Basically, for context, the bourgeois, if you ever hear that word, nowadays usually refers to anything of the ruling class. Originally, it meant basically the upper middle class, people who were well off enough to own businesses and whatnot, but weren't necessarily the aristocrats of the time period. They weren't lords and ladies. They were those that were beneath lords and ladies, but those who still owned wealth and property. That's the original term of bourgeois. Which, I mean, the meaning hasn't necessarily changed. It's just... should have dodged better. I don't know. Were any of those random facts sufficient? Or should I get you something else? I can come up with more. Those are just kind of the ones running through my head at the moment. You could always go for more. How about this one, which I don't think... It's been so long since I've streamed. But here's one. Vegetables don't exist, botanically speaking. Culinarily, they are a food group, but they are nonsensical. It's why the fruit and vegetables discussion doesn't make sense. Why you have things like tomatoes, which are technically a fruit, culinarily speaking. It's because vegetables... they don't actually exist. There isn't a kind of part of a plant that is a vegetable. When we say vegetables, we could mean stems, we could mean fruits, we could mean flowers. In the case of, like, broccoli is a flower. Squash, pumpkin, is a fruit. Potatoes are a tuber. Carrots are a root. Bananas are a berry. Strawberries are not. They are ovipositories. Nope, that's the wrong word. That is very much the wrong word. And I cannot remember the right word right now. Strawberries are not really a fruit either. They are kind of their own unique thing that's probably closer to a flower. But yeah, vegetables are made up. They don't exist. What defines them culinarily speaking generally tends to be, does this thing taste sweet? If it tastes sweet enough, it's a fruit. If it doesn't quite taste sweet enough, they call it a vegetable. There is very, very... Yeah, it's a very, very wrong word. I'm going to Google it now. Because I very much named a very, very wrong word there. And no, we are not going to explain what the other word is. This is a family-friendly stream. It's an aggregate accessory fruit, meaning the fleshy part is derived not from the plant's ovaries, but from the receptacle that holds the ovaries. There you go. When you talk about plants, it gets just oddly sounding inappropriate, but not. Lay eggs. That's true. There's other. That is very true, scientifically speaking. Yep. There. It is also used for. I learned much in a class I had to take for school that was about adults' health and development. And there is, we will say, a certain kind of adult entertainment device called that. Do not Google. I know much more than my ace self ever wants to know. We will put it that way. Anyway, I do really actually appreciate that class though, because, like, y'all, America's, like, education system when it comes to that stuff sucks. Really sucks. And, like, I look at back at what I learned at high school, and it is amazing. It is amazing that there weren't more pregnancies at my high school, given how little they actually taught us in terms of safety. Like, I'm from Utah. Utah practices a abstinence as the only form of taught prevention. It doesn't really go into anything else. It kind of like maybe lightly touches on them. It's very, very fear tactic-y, which doesn't actually help students because then they are left with insufficient knowledge on the fact that they are still teenagers and aren't going to listen to whatever rules you put in front of them. And all you have done is make sure that they don't know the proper way to do it. Education is prevention, exactly. And we just change blows to death. But yep, education is prevention. Speaking of which, this is very, very random. I know I run a family-friendly stream. If y'all ever have, like, this goes out to anyone, if y'all ever have questions about something that you feel like you don't really know how to ask someone else, feel free to DM me. I know a lot about this stuff because of my background in pharmacy. So, like, if you're like, what is this for? What's precautions I should take in this situation? Like, feel free to DM me. I'm more than willing to help answer these questions, especially because American system is terrible. Like, I don't mind odd, weird questions. Just DM me. It's just between me and you, and I will happily do whatever I can to help you. At the very least, if I don't know, point you in the direction of resources that can help. Just because it can be very, very hard and awkward to ask, and I'm just saying, you're more than welcome to ask me. I'm Ace, so no worries, I won't take it weird. It's all foreign to me, I just look at it to try to help. More random things going off on my phone. Also, just my DMs are always open. If you ever need someone to talk to, feel free to DM me. I'll respond when I can. If I don't respond, it's probably because I'm busy. Because, trust me, if I get a DM, I want to respond to it. Partially because it's just a FOMO. FOMO makes me respond to messages usually very quickly. Quickly. Like, it doesn't like give me anxiety. I don't want people like to worry about giving me anxiety, but like if you send me a message, I want to respond like as soon as I can. Or like if there's a group chat that I happen to be part of, I will respond pretty quickly, like, or even like if I don't have to be part of it. I tend to be the kind to over respond to group chats. Just because, like, I want to be part of the conversation, and sharing life stories is like my, there's a word for like my communication language. Someone knows what I'm talking about. I show empathy and listening by adding my own stories and experiences to things, which sometimes comes across as attention stealing. I never mean it to be. That's just how I empathize. That is me going, I understand you. And I'm going to try to show that I understand you and aren't just saying I understand you because by sharing my also equally bad story and experience I had about something similar. It's a very common thing amongst neurodivergent people. So, whether that's ADD, ADHD, I don't know which one of those is correct. I don't know if either of those are still correct. Autism, schizophrenia, like it's a very common trait amongst anyone with some kind of neurodivergency. Have I gotten to play Genshin off stream? Unfortunately, no. I swung the wrong way, but I got my souls back at least. I have had zero chance to play Genshin off stream. I have not played Genshin since, I think, the last time I played Genshin was when I played with Drew and y'all. You, Drew, and Mare. That was the last time I've had a chance to play Genshin. I haven't touched my computer. In like 2.5 weeks. Do I know the new? I know that new stuff has been added. I don't know what exactly was added. And I know that it sounds pretty good from what you and Mare are saying. About to be a lot of souls gone away. Maybe not. You came around that corner real nice and slow. There's your other friend. Is it really good? I know they added a couple new characters. Oh, we actually dropped something. Apparently, he's just going to go for a walk off the edge. May or may not have to deal with him later. You get a pocket dimension and a way to decorate the outside and inside of your house. I don't have a house yet, so that's new. I didn't know Genshin had houses, so. You get to decorate. That's really cool. Let's go find the other guy. Is he still kicking around over here? Like, I don't want him to, like, ambush me later. If he went off that way, he was gone forever. He, like, fought on this hole? I'm assuming he just gone forever. It's new. Okay. Third time's the charm with this guy. Suck it. Okay. I like the ability, the sound of being able to decorate my home. The real question is, can you have friends over in your home? And that's the real question. I knew you were still around. I knew you hadn't left me that easily. Good to see you again, buddy. That looks like a very cruel trap. There's an arrow guy. I remember you now. Yep, you can have friends over. It's very tempting. That's very... Oh, I need to give that a play. So, I suppose for context, this week, and I don't have much of a schedule this week, it's kind of all up in the air, but the tentative schedule, not schedule, is that tomorrow I will be playing Minecraft with Drew. We'll be getting back into the swing of that. And Saturday should be the return of the Call of Cthulhu session streams. Kind of getting, basically picking right back up into my old weekly schedule. And then Sunday will kind of probably... We're still trying to figure out... I'm going to say the wins to when I stream. Because I do have... Like, my job hours are shifting around a little bit. I got... My wife and kids are with me again. Which is wonderful. But I do want to help out with the kids. I'm... Very much... I very much dislike the concept that it is a mother's job to take care of children. So, while I am admittedly not the best at it, I try to do everything I can to help my wife with the kids. So, making sure that I'm streaming at times where I can be there to help with the kids still, and not, like, stepping out of the picture type deal. So yeah. Like, my schedule will be changing, but I still want to be... I remember these streaming as much as possible. Oh, that's a thing. What kind of blasphemy is this? How much is that going to heal? Is that going to heal all the way? Maybe it will, actually. Radiant Life Gems for the win. Old Radiant Life Gems, actually. I'm impressed. Don't know how to deal with this. I don't know if I can deal with it. So I will run away. Dang it, I hate this place. I really do dislike this place. What time is it? 1:30? Y'all, we're gonna switch to some Genshin. We're gonna switch to some Genshin for like the last 30 minutes I can stream today, at least. Unless there's any objections. Just give me a moment to get it swapped over. This camera in the top right work for Genshin. I'm trying to think. Bottom left is a little bit better. I believe bottom left's a little better. Okay. And now we boot up Genshin. I'm trying to get my wife to actually. So. I was talking to my wife, and she's been kind of interested in Genshin. She's watched me play. But she doesn't have a phone or computer that can run it well. But now that I'm back, she can use my computer, and I can use my phone. So I'm like, why don't you play Genshin on my computer? And if you're game, we could try to stream it. And we can have my wife's first experience playing Genshin. So. That's what I would like to do. We will see if he puts up my with my antics long enough to do that, but that's what I want to do. We are currently updating. It is going very fast. I've already downloaded to 5% and just started it a moment ago. We are now at 7%, so we're going pretty quick. I'm going to take this as a chance to stand up, get some something. I don't know, probably like a little fruit snack or something like that, because I'm a bit peckish. And I will be back soon. Well, this is just updating. I mean, we're at 15% right now, so this shouldn't be a long update. Anyway, BRB, everyone. My headset is off, but this is my kitty. Try to get some kitty purrs. I don't know if you can hear those kitty purrs. I don't know if you could hear any of those ones either. My mic's probably not the best at picking up purrs. But yes, I have my cat back. This is my producer. She is... Yeah. I've had her for a while. I've missed her for 7 months. I went to go get me a snack, and there, this little treat was. So, she's wandered off now. There is a TV stand roughly right next to my desk that she can wander onto. She has wandered off to that to explore, as cats do. Well, hi. Don't knock anything over. I know you have ideas. We are still updating. It's almost done. It's 96% installed. My cat's taking off. She may or may not make another appearance. She sometimes likes to sit on my shoulders. You saw like that. Like, I'll carry around like that for a bit. It's kind of like her go-to. I'm going to perch. I'm going to look over your shoulder. You're going to hold my butt and my back legs, and I'll just purr at you. Usually it means that, you know, she needs water or something. Today just happened to be love. Just wanted some love there for a moment. And I say that because she has both food in her bowl and water is full. So. I don't know. Unless there's something else she was trying to mooch, I'm going to pretend that she wanted just love and affection. Are you just going to stare at me in the hallway now? That's what it is. I'm not in bed. She's giving me the you're not in bed look. I didn't realize Genshin was going to have this much of a download. Here, let me try to screen capture this real quick. I don't know if this will work, but you can kind of actually see where we are. It's now verifying. Let's see if launcher.exe will capture. The answer is no. No, it won't. But will window capture? Hello, darkness, my old friend. That's not really window capture, but good try. So window capture does not. Okay. Well, that's fine. I mean, it hasn't got too much left to go. Beneath the light of Jadite. Jadite? Maybe. Isn't this a bad dude? He He looks like he's one of them, like, for Chewies. Is that how it's said? It's been too long since I played Genshin. My mind does not last 2 weeks. I'm staring at a dude with, like, gray pointed shoulders, like a purple button-up shirt, fancy white ascot tie with a golden brooch at top, black trench coat, lots of tassels, and then there's, like, ground dragon monster behind him. And he just reminds me of, like, the Fachuis or whatever they're called. The bad ones. He's got orange eyes. Fatui, that's the one. No, there's no hat here. He's got, like, a smolder pose going on. Oh, wait. No mask. Nope, that doesn't work. I was going to get creative and turn one screen to look at the other for a second. But alas, it did not work. Due to the fact that this has wires connected to it in, like, 6 different places. Can I get a pick? Yeah, I can try to do screen cap. I'll put it in the Discord real quick. I'll just throw it in general real quick. If Discord will open, nice. General. Shooting the breeze. Boop. This dude. Whoever that is. We're now launching, by the way. Zhongli. Is that their name? He's not Fatui. Good to know. Someone should tell him that. Oh no, y'all will see my old junk email. What am I to do? Probably should block that. I probably should be more secure about this. Here. Boop. I hit it. I've shown up on stream before. I don't use that email for anything, so. It's making me verify that I'm a human. Interesting. Click to begin. Apparently we got download still. It likes to download a lot. I don't have the longest that I can play tonight, unfortunately. And these downloads are kind of chipping into that a little bit. Unfortunately, I do have work tomorrow. So, poopy. I'll at least hop in and play for a moment or two. Maybe. Yeah, it depends how long the housing quest. How long would you say the housing quest take? And is it something that I can do, or is there going to be like a bunch of things I need to do before it? Because I am all for getting house. You don't know? That's fine. Didn't expect you to like know the answer offhand. I was just thinking out loud. It's good to be back streaming. I've missed y'all. I missed y'all. Getting some Genshin going. Music for this game is legit, but it's putting me to sleep. I'm glad you missed me. Sorry that it ended up being so much longer than expected. I had a very optimistic view of stream the week before I pack, stream while driving, and then stream like the first day that I was in here. I didn't get even get internet set up for 2 days. So, like, yeah. I felt so bad for work. I work for a very small shipping company, which has been mentioned before. And my bosses and my coworkers are all amazing people. I love all of them. Just good people. And I was originally planning to do like work in the hotels, and none of it would work for me. I do accounting, and I couldn't just do, like do any invoices. So the other accountant ended up having to do like all of it for the week that I was gone, and I'm like, I'm so sorry. Okay. We are here. We got lots of notifications. Let's check these first. Genshin is a bit oof. Genshin's feeling a bit de-boops de-boops. Oh no, what? Oh, I don't have. Yeah, I don't have Linu. Linu. Well, Diluc, you don't need to bribe me with food. And is that mimosas? No, it's apple cider. You don't need to bribe me with food, Diluc. I love you anyway. Oh, he's Geo. Is he a good Geo user? I've not liked any of the other Geos that I've tried.
Once, there was a glorious kingdom established among
What
the
is
heavens.
this?
From that kingdom came a crowned heir. Tasked with
I feel like I've
seeking out
already
the
watched
Genesis
this.
Pearl from the Kingdom of Darkness. The first crowned heir began her journey of seeking the pearl. But she was deceived, and the memory of her noble origins faded. She now believed that she was the queen of the Kingdom of Darkness. But take heart. A second crowned heir had already taken up the path where the first had stumbled. This is the story of your journey.
Okay.
Of your tale to be told.
Good to know for the story quests. That was like slightly different, but I feel like I've already been told that before. Oh well. The book. Are we laggy? I'm getting some lag on my end too, just because of... I know Twitch has been struggling tonight. Oh, buffering. Is it acting up again? We'll have to watch. I had to restart the stream once before, given the time. If the lagging doesn't clear up on its own, I'll probably have to switch. I will be hardwiring my computer. Just to prevent lagginess in the future, but... There's not much I can do now, unfortunately. You still lagging? I did watch this. Oh, that buffering has got you on a big delay. You use Berserker, don't you? You primarily don't, but you do. Double crit damage. And the energy recharge isn't bad to have. Okay. Oh, mushroom. Mushroom. Let's refresh in a day. Okay. You think it's good now? Okay. I am going to do... I'm going to do some polls real quick. I might as well. Just see if I get lucky. Nice. Always like some Pharaoh's Shadow. Good. Speak softly, there's a big stick to carry. The Raven Bow. Nice. another item. Skyrider sword. Okay, let's get some of them junk poles out of the way.
I smell rabbit.
I feel like that would be good to go. Okay. What should we do first? I do know I have expedition rewards. I had quests, though. Quests are a good thing. Map. Nope, not map. That's the wrong one. It is the adventure handbook? Nope. Journal. Quests. The one that says quests. Duh. Alright. It does look like this is the right one. Lupicol. Commission quests. I have some decent ones to do. Definitely quite a few options for us to pick up. Oh. I hate to really not play Genshin longer, but I'm falling asleep, though, is the problem. Body's like, it's two, it's time to sleep shut now. Okay, maybe let's do a couple quick quests. We got some poles in. I figured some Genshin poles. I knew I'd had some saved up. Not really, but I got some. I am going to try to fit this in. I'm going to be playing a little bit off stream myself, probably. Do some grinding. Get some more. Kind of get towards the new a bit, maybe. Get some Prima Gems. I'm going to try to, at least. To do some more poles. I'm honestly not quite, like, terribly excited by either of the two that we have up for pull right now. Doesn't mean I don't want them. I'm just they don't quite call to me the way that Venti did. As it were. Yeah, but do you think I'm gonna wrap up here? Didn't get any luck with the pulls tonight. That's okay. We got some decent progress for Dark Souls. I'll just wrap up here and do a raid before I start to crash a lot more. But I do want to try to maybe fit a little bit of a Genshin stream in tomorrow as well. Either before or after the part that I do with Drew. Zhongli has a cool fighting style. That's good to know. I will keep that in mind. Because that's actually... I'll do the trials tomorrow on stream. Kind of get my thoughts on it, see if it's something that I do really want. In the meantime, I think a cuddly raid is in order. Yeah. I do want to say, though, just thank all of you for joining today. I assume Pokemon Snap, that'll be fun. Thank all of you for joining me today. It's good to be back. I'm going to be streaming a lot more regularly soon. I'm kind of getting back into the swing of things. Thank you for bearing with me a little bit on, you know, a bit of a bumpy stream to some extent. We had some lag issues and stuff. But, yeah, just thank all of you for joining me. All of you have a good night. I hope you get all the rest that you need. I hope tomorrow's is a good day. If it's your, like, Friday, I hope it's a good way to wrap up the week and celebrate into the weekend, whatever you do. Just remember, you know, real life can be tough sometimes, but you're always welcome back here. I love all of you. Good night.